In this video, we will talk about how to create reproducible and observable notebooks with hex. There are three parts to this video. Firstly, we will talk about the disadvantage of Jupyter notebooks and how that can be solved with hex. Secondly, we will talk about some benefits of hex. And lastly, we will talk about how to integrate hex into a prefetched pipeline. Jupyter Notebook is a popular tool for data scientists to explore and process data because of its ease to check code outputs. However, there are several drawbacks to Jupyter Notebook. The first issue is interpretability issue. As your code gets bigger, the relationship between cells become increasingly complex. Thus, when cell changes, it's difficult to know which cells to execute next. The second issue is reproducibility issue. Since cells in a notebook can be executed in any order, executing the same notebook in a different order might result in different outputs. The third issue is versioning issue. It is difficult to compare the changes between two different versions of a notebook with Git. Luckily, all of these problems can be solved with hex notebooks. Hex allows you to link cells through their dependencies and execute only the cells whose dependencies change. In the next session, you will learn some useful features of hex. What is hex? Hex is a modern data workspace that makes it easy to connect to data sources and create reproducible notebooks. The first feature of hex that I really like is the ability to connect to data sources easily. To connect to a data source, I will click this data source button. To add a new data source, click Add. Here, let's click Create Data Connection and see the options that hex provide. We can see that there are a lot of popular databases in here. If you click one database, you can see that there are boxes to insert the information about Postgres. After creating a data source, you can query it by creating a SQL cell, choose a data source, and write a SQL query. And we got the table from the database right inside our notebook. Another advantage of hex is the ability to use both SQL and Python to analyze the data. For example, I might use segmented, which is the output of this SQL cell, for the next Python cell to create a histogram for the data. This is very convenient for those who want to use both SQL and Python in the same notebook. The third feature of hex is the ability to understand the relationships between cells with a graph view. To open the graph view, click Graph. And you can see the graph view of the entire notebook. The node represents the cell, and the edges show the dependencies between cells. By looking at this graph, we know how cells are related to each other. The fourth feature of hex is the ability to only re-execute a cell when its dependencies change. When an input changes, hex will automatically rerun only the cells that use that input. For example here, when I update the value of the variable y, the cells that use the y variable automatically rerun. Thus, you no longer need to spend time finding the cells to execute and spend resources running unrelated cells. With hex, you can compare the difference between versions of a notebook by clicking the History and Versions tab. Now you have all the changes that you made inside one notebook. Another cool feature of hex is to create a dynamic report with built-in widgets such as button, checkbox, date, dropdown, multi-select, number input, slider, and so on. Here I created a drop-down for the y variable. Now if I change the input y, I will have a different output for the cell that uses y. Hex also allows you to create a simple chart through a nice GUI. Now we have a nice scatter plot. If you want to hide all the code, you can click App in the top of the notebook, and you will have a dashboard with our code. This is very useful if you want to present the insights to your CEO or stakeholders. That's it about hex features. In the next video, you will learn how to integrate hex into your data pipeline with Prefit.